गुड मॉर्निंग स्टूडेंट्स, टुडे आई एम हियर विद योर न्यू चैप्टर दैट इज ग्रेविटेशन. ओके, व्हाट इज ग्रेविटेशन, व्हाट यू मीन बाय द ग्रेविटेशन, लेट्स सी. इन प्रीवियस क्लास वी लर्नड अबाउट फोर्स एंड मोशन. ओके, फोर्स ऑफ द ऑब्जेक्ट एंड मोशन ऑफ एन ऑब्जेक्ट, दिस आर ऑल द टॉपिक्स वी लर्नड इन द प्रीवियस क्लास. वी नो दैट ए फोर्स कैन चेंज द स्पीड ऑफ द ऑब्जेक्ट and a force can change the direction of the object. Okay, in the same thing the gravitation is also a force. Okay, same thing, the gravitation is also a force or force of attraction, and it was discovered by a famous scientist, Newton. Okay, Newton was discovered the gravitational force. Okay, one day Newton was sitting under a tree. Okay, when he was sitting under a tree, an apple fell on him. Okay, the fall of apple made Newton to start thinking. Okay, thinking, he start to thinking about the reason, what is the reason for apple fell down. Okay, and he discovered the gravitation. Okay, yeah, we always observe that an object dropped from a height, the falls towards the ground. Okay, if suppose here the object falls or dropped from a height, okay, it's here is a ground. Okay, this is a ground. The object dropped from a certain height, it falls down. Okay, it falls down and reaches to ground. Okay, this is because of gravitational force. Or when we are throwing on an object, okay, for example, this is an object. When I am throwing it upwards, okay, when I am throwing it upwards, it attains some height. Okay, it attains a certain height and falls down, and it comes to the initial position. Okay, initial state. For example, here is a ground. This is a ground. When I am throwing a object to upwards, okay, it attains some height. Okay, it attains some height, and again it comes to the ground. Okay, it comes to the ground. Okay, it's an object I am throwing from ground. Okay, when I am throwing an object upwards, it attains some height. This is a height. Okay, it goes some height and comes back. Okay, and comes to the ground. Okay, it comes to the ground or initial state. This because of the earth having some attractive force. Okay, the earth attracts the object. Okay, that's why the object comes to the ground. Okay, that attractive force is called the gravitational force. So the earth having a gravitational force. Okay, not only earth. Okay, the other things which are present in our universe, all the things acting some force. Okay, all the objects in the universe acting some force, that force we call it as a gravitational force. Okay, for example the solar system. Okay, the sun and the sun. All the planets, we know that all the planets revolve around the sun. Okay, here is a earth. Here the planets. Okay, these are all planets. All the planets revolve around the sun. Okay, the sun and the other planets, between the sun and the other planets. Okay, here is a sun and the planet. Okay, the sun, between the sun and the planet, some force is acting. Okay, some force is acting between the sun and the other planet. Okay, that acting force is called a gravitational force. Okay, we know that the moon goes around the earth, and then all the planets revolve around the sun. Okay, Newton could grasp that the same force is responsible for all these things. Okay, that is called gravitational force. Okay, a force or gravitational force is nothing but a force of attraction, or the force acting by the objects. Okay, in previous class we learnt about the force is directly proportional to the mass. Okay, that is F is proportional to the M. Okay, in previous class we learnt about the force is directly proportional to the mass. It means if the mass is increases, okay, when we are increasing the mass, the force will automatically increases. Okay, if the mass is decreases, the force will decreases. Okay, we learned that in the previous class, the force is directly proportional to the mass of the object. Okay, mass of the object, I explained it with an example. Okay, you consider in two objects. Okay, consider in two objects. Okay, I'll take in two objects. This is one object and this is another object. Okay, we are considering a two objects. Okay, it having a mass, how much? 1 kg. Okay, it having a mass 1 kg, and here also it having a 1 kg, and the force is acting in this direction. Okay, this object, the force acting in this direction. Okay, what about the force? The force is force F is equal to 1 newton. Okay, because of the force is directly proportional to the mass of the object. Okay, here also same. Okay, the force how much? 1 newton. If when I am increasing the mass of this object, okay, when I am adding a another object, or if I am increasing this object is 2 kg. Okay, if increasing the mass of this object 2 kg, what about the force? The force is equal to 2 newtons. Okay, 2 newtons. Here the mass of this object is 1 kg. Okay, we know that the force is directly proportional to the mass of an object. Then here 2 kg, it means force is equal to 2 newton. 2 into 1, when I am combining the force of the two objects, okay, it will be product. Okay, 2 into 1, how much? 2 newtons. If suppose I am increasing this object as 3 kg, okay, if the mass of the this object is 3 kg and the mass of this object is 2 kg, then what will be the force? The force F is equal to here 3 newtons. F is equal to 3 newtons, here 2 newtons. When I am combining the force of two objects, it will becomes 3 to the 6 newtons. Okay, 6 newtons. Okay, by observing this, okay, when I am increasing the mass of the object, the force will increases. Okay, when I am decreasing the mass of the object, the force will decreases. Okay, thus the force is directly proportional to the mass of the object. Here we learn one more concept, that is distance. Okay, if the distance between the two object, okay, if the distance between the two object is r, okay, then the force is inversely proportional to the square of the distance. Okay, here square of distance means d square. Okay, the force is inversely proportional to the square of the distance. Okay, how the force is inversely proportional to the square of the distance? Okay, I'll explain this with an example. Okay, let's see. The force is inversely proportional to the square of the distance. Okay, for example, the distance between the two objects, considering two objects. Okay, now the distance between these two objects is r. Okay, the distance between the two objects is r. It having a mass, yeah, we know that is just 2 kg, and this is 3 kg, and the both the objects, the distance between the both the object is r. Okay, when I am increasing the distance, okay, if suppose I am increasing the distance like this, okay, when I am increasing the distance to the double, okay, double of this distance, it will becomes 2r. Okay, when I am increasing the distance of the object, okay, r to the 2r. Now the distance of two object is r, then what will becomes to the force? Okay, the force is directly proportional to the mass of the object. It means m1 into m2, it means 3 into 2 divided by square of the distance, which means 2r whole square. Okay, now the F proportional to the 3 to the 6, 6 divided by 2 square is 4 newtons. Okay, the force is 6 divided by 4 newtons. Okay, now this is the actual distance. Okay, this is the actual distance of the two objects. Okay, when I am decreases the distance of two objects, okay, when I am decreases, it means half of this, okay, half of the this, when I am decreases the distance, it means r by 2, half of the r. When I am decreases the distance, then what will happens the force? Let's see. Okay, the force is directly proportional to the mass of the object, it means 3 into 2, and inversely proportional to the direction, okay, sorry, distance, square of the distance, it means r by 2 whole square. Okay, r by 2 whole square. Now the force is proportional to the 6 divided by 1 by 4. Now denominator is goes to the numerator, that is the force is proportional to the, it will becomes a product. Okay, 6 into 4, that is a force proportional to the 10 newtons. Okay, by observe this and this. Okay, when the direction, distance is increases, the force will decreases. When the distance increases between the two objects, the force will decreases. When the distance is decreases between the two objects, then the force is increase. Okay, this is the relation. Thus, the force is inversely proportional to the square of the distance. As the force is inversely proportional to the square of the distance. Okay, now considering two object. Okay, considering two object of mass m1 and m2. Here, is there one object here m1. This mass is m1. Here, mass of this object is m2. And these are at a distance. Okay, two objects are in distance of d. Okay, the distance between the two object is d. And what will be the force? Yeah, force. We know that the force is directly proportional to the product of their mass. Okay, the mass m1 and into m2 and inversely proportional to the square of the distance. That is equal to d square. Okay, the distance between the two object is d square. The force is acting of this object is in this direction, and the for this object is this direction. Okay. Okay. Now. Now we have to remove the proportionality. Okay, now we have to remove the proportionality by taking a proportional constant, that is F is equal to some proportional constant G. I'll take a G into M1 M2 divided by D square. Okay, yeah, G into M1 M2 divided by D square. Here G is the universal gravitational constant. G is universal. Okay, here universal gravitational constant. Okay, gravitational constant, and its value, the value of the G is equal to 6.67 into 10 power minus 11. Okay, the value of the G is a universal gravitational constant, and the value of G is 6.67 into 10 power minus 11. Okay, what is the SI unit of G? Okay, what is the SI unit of G? Let's see. Okay, we know that F is equal to G into M1 M2 divided by D square. Okay, now we have to write this formula in terms of G. Okay, G is equal to F D square. We have to cross multiplication. Okay, we have to do the cross multiplication. F D square divided by M1 and M2. Okay, we know that what is the SI unit of force? That is Newton. And what's the SI unit of distance? Distance is measured in meter square. Okay, here distance square, so meter square. Here m1 kg into m2 kg. Okay, now the Newton meter square divided by kg into kg is kg square. Okay, the SI unit of G is Newton meter square per kg square. Okay, this is the SI unit of G. Okay, the value of G is 6.67 into 10 power minus 11 Newton meter square per kg square. Okay, here G is the universal gravitational constant. This is the universal law of gravitation. Okay, what is the universal law of gravitation? Okay, what is the universal law of gravitation? The force which is directly proportional to the product of their mass. Okay, M1 into M2, product of their mass, and inversely proportional to the square of the distance. Okay, square of the distance is called a universal law of gravitation. What is the universal law of gravitation? A force is directly proportional to the product of their mass and inversely proportional to the square of the distance. Okay, this is the universal law of gravitation. Okay students, in this class we learned about the gravitation and universal law of gravitation. Okay, in next class we will discuss about importance of the universal law of gravitation and next concept, that is free fall. Okay, thank you.